area, distance, speed is the vector.
Capacitance across PQ is equal to S. Take a capacitor. This end is P. This end is PQ. The area of each plate is A. The separation between these two plates is D. D is the separation between these two plates. Separation between these two plates is D. Okay. Now, dielectrics are filled in between these two plates. Dielectrics. Three dielectrics are filled. Now this is one dielectric. It is one dielectric. This dielectric constant K1. One dielectric K1. Okay. Now here the distance is divided into half. Next here two dielectrics are filled. Two dielectrics. One dielectric is kept above and another dielectric is kept. Okay, so here in this process the area is half. Area becomes to half. So here this is dielectric constant K2. This is dielectric constant K3. How many dielectrics are filled here? Three dielectrics are filled. Here the area is divided into two parts. And the distance is also given. That's why it is called area distance division method. Okay? Right. Okay, so this is dielectric constant, dielectric constant KA. Okay, here it is another dielectric constant K3. How many dielectrics are here? Three dielectrics are here. Okay, we want to find out the effective capacitance of this capacitor. Effective capacitance of this capacitor. How to find out the effective capacitance of this capacitor? Okay, first, divide the circuit into here, the distance becomes to half. The circuit is split into two times. The capacitor is divided into two times. One across this distance, okay, in this way. Another one is K1 and K2. Area is divided. So the circuit is changed as like this. Okay. Next, the circuit becomes to as like this. This circuit becomes to three capacitors. Okay, this is one, here is one, here is one. Okay. It becomes to three capacitors as like this. Okay. Okay. This is P, this one is Q. What is the dielectric here? K1. Here the dielectric is K2. Here the dielectric is K3. So here again three dielectrics are filled here. Three dielectrics. How many dielectrics here? Three dielectrics. Okay. Dielectrics are filled here. Okay. Now, in this capacitor, what is the area of each plate?
A. Area of each plate will be the same. So the area of each plate of this capacitor A, what is the distance between these two plates?
D by 2.
Here the distance becomes 2 half. That's why the distance between these two plates is
D by 2.
What about this capacitor? What is the area of each plate?
A by 2.
Very good. Area of each plate A by 2. Distance between these two plates?
D by 2.
Okay. The distance is half. So, the distance is D upon 2. Here is also same. Area becomes to A by 2. Distance becomes to B upon 2. Okay. What is the capacitance of this capacitor?
K1 epsilon 1.
Okay, right. Okay, it is to be named as C1. C1 is equal to K1 epsilon 0 A upon
D by 2.
That is equal to
2 K1
epsilon 0 A upon
B.
Similarly, okay. The capacitance of this capacitor C2 is equal to
K2
epsilon naught
A by 2.
A by 2 is its area plate.
Yes.
A by 2
upon, D
upon
D
distance between these two plates is
D by 2.
2 to get cancel each other, that is equal to K2
epsilon
naught A upon
D.
Okay. What is the capacitance of this capacitor?
K3
epsilon naught. Okay. Similarly, as like this one, these two are same. So the difference is only that. So C3 is equal to
K3
epsilon naught A upon. Okay. Next. Now, these two capacitors are in parallel. Okay. We want to find out the effective capacitance of these two capacitors first. Effective capacitance. What is the formula for if two capacitors are in parallel?
C is equal to
C1 plus C2. Here C2, C3 are there. That's why. What is the formula?
C2
plus C3. So the two capacitors becomes a single capacitor. These two are in parallel. Okay? Parallel. So here C2 and C3 are in parallel. Parallel. So in parallel combination, now C2.
K2
epsilon naught A upon B plus
C3.
K3 epsilon naught A upon
B.
What is the common factor here?
Epsilon
naught A by D is the common factor upon D is the common factor K2 plus
K3.
Right. Now this is the resultant capacitance. Now we have simply removed these two capacitors. In the place of these two capacitors, we are only using one capacitor. Its capacitance is epsilon naught A by D times K1 plus
K2.
Okay, right. So, again the circuit becomes true. The circuit can be changed as like this. Again the circuit. So, this capacitor remains the same. This capacitance C1 remains the same. C1 remains the same. C1 is equal to, what is its capacitance?
2K1
epsilon naught A
upon
D. Right. Okay, here in the place of these two capacitors, we are using only C1 capacitor. That is equal to CT is equal to, what is the formula?
Epsilon
naught
A
upon D times K2 plus
K3.
Now, this end is D, this end is nulls. these two capacitors are in
series.
Okay. In series combination, what is the formula of capacitor? Series combination Cs is equal to C1 Cb upon C1 plus C, as like C1 C2 by C1 plus C. In the place of C1, we are using, okay, substitute all these values in this part. Simply, we can get the effective capacitance of this capacitor. Okay? Okay, substitute this one. That is equal to, in the place of C1, 2K1 epsilon naught A upon B into Cb. Epsilon naught A upon B times K2 plus K3 upon C1 plus C2. 2K1 epsilon naught A upon B plus epsilon naught A upon B times K2 plus
K3.
K2 plus K3. Okay. Here. That is equal to, that is equal to, okay, the upper term is saying 2k1 epsilon naught A upon B times epsilon naught A upon B, epsilon naught A upon B times k2 plus k3. Upper term remains same. In the lower term, which one is common? Epsilon naught A by B is common. Epsilon naught A upon B is the common term. Times
2K1.
2K1
plus K2
plus K2 plus
K3.
Okay? 2K1 plus of K2 plus K3.
Cancel.
Okay. Now, what are cancel?
Epsilon naught A by B.
Epsilon naught. Epsilon naught. A. B. B. Cancel. Okay. So, now, what is the form? What is the final form?
2K1 epsilon naught A by B.
2.
K1.
2 epsilon naught A upon B into K1 times K1 times K2 plus K3 upon 2K1 plus K2
plus K3.
Okay? Find capacitance across P and Q. P and Q. Okay? Right. Take a capacitor. Again, take a capacitor. Now, this is the capacitor. This terminal is P. This one is Q. The area of each plate is A. That is, distance between these two plates is B. Okay? Right. Now, here the capacitor, two directrices are placed in this capacitor. Two directrices. Okay. Here two directrices. These are two directrices. Its directrice constant K1, its directrice constant K2. Only two directrices are placed. Two directrices. These are two directrices. the upper body is in A.
Okay.
Now we want to find out the capacitance. Here the circuit, the capacitor is divided in two times. One is area wise, next distance wise. Okay. The circuit can be converted as like this. Okay. Here three capacitors are there. 1, 2, 3 capacitors. Okay. Now the circuit becomes to as like this. This is P. This one is Q. Now here in between these two plates, A is there. What is the area of this plate?
A by 2.
A by 2 because this area is A by 2. Total area of this plate is A. Half of the area, that's why its area A by 2. Distance between these two plates remains the same, D. So distance is D. Distance between these two plates is D. What is its capacitance? C1 is equal to
epsilon naught
A by 2 upon
D.
That is equal to
epsilon naught A upon 2D
is its capacitance. Okay. Now, here in between these two plates, dielectric constant is K1. It is the dielectric constant between these two plates. Okay. What is the area of this plate?
A by 2.
Here, the area of this plate is A by 2, half of the area. So, A by 2 is the area. Distance between the plates?
D by 2.
Here, the distance also becomes to half. So, the distance between these two plates, D by 2. So, what is the capacitance of this capacitor? C2 is equal to
K1 epsilon naught A by 2 upon D by 2.
K1 epsilon naught A by 2 upon D by 2. Two do get cancelled each other. That is equal to
K1 epsilon naught A upon D.
Okay, now in between these two plates, what is the dielectric?
K2
is the dielectric. Okay, here also area of each plate is A by 2. Distance between these two plates is D by 2. What is its capacitance?
C3
is equal to, these two are similar.
K2 epsilon naught.
But only the difference is dielectric constant. So K2
epsilon
as like this one. K2 epsilon naught A upon D. Now these two capacitors are in series combination. So first solve these two. These two are series. C2 and C3 are in series combination. What is the effective capacitance in series combination? Cs is equal to
C2 upon C2 plus C3.
Substitute C2 C3 values in this formula. C2 C3 values. Okay. What is C2?
K1 epsilon naught A upon D.
Thanks. What is C3?
K2 epsilon naught A upon D.
Upon C1 plus C2, which term is common?
Epsilon naught A upon D.
Times
K1 plus K2.
Which are cancelled?
Epsilon naught A upon D.
What are cancelled in this one? Epsilon naught A get cancelled. D get cancelled. Okay. But is it? Okay, first, right, epsilon naught A upon D into
K1 plus K2.
Okay, now remove these two capacitors. In the place of these two capacitors, we are using only single capacitor. Its capacitance is epsilon naught A by D times K1 plus K2. Okay, right. Change this one. Change this circuit. Okay. Upper capacitor remains the same. So, C1 this capacitance is C1, it remains the same. C1 is equal to
epsilon naught A upon.
Epsilon naught A upon 2D, it remains the same. Okay. In the place of P, this is T. This one is T2. In the place of these two capacitors, we are using single capacitor. Single capacitor. Its capacitance
C
is equal to
epsilon
naught A upon B times
K1, K2.
K1, K2 upon K1 plus K2. Okay? Now, these two capacitors are in
parallel.
C1 and Cs are in parallel. These two are in parallel. C1 and Cs are in parallel. Okay. In parallel combination, simply we are adding the capacitances of these two capacitors to find the resultant capacitance. Okay. Is equal to C1 plus Cs. That is equal to, in the place of C1,
epsilon
naught A upon 2D plus, in the place of Cs,
epsilon
naught A upon B times
K1,
K2 upon K1 plus K2. What is the common factor in these two?
Epsilon
naught A by D. Epsilon naught A upon E is the common term of plus
K1,
K2 upon K1 plus
K2.
Okay, go on. Now this is the capacitance between resultant capacitance of this.